Welcome to the next problem, development of cylinder. Here you can see this is the cylinder which has got top surface, bottom surface and the vertical height. Top and bottom are circle having diameter D, height H. In order to do the development, the formula is pi D, and D is the base diameter. If you substitute, you will get the measurement. With the measurement, do the length. Height is equal to h. It will be a rectangle. This is the development. In the manufacturing sector, we have to do the development and keep it as a template. And this template is transferred onto a fresh sheet. Mark the dimensions, and you can see two arrows. We have to fold it back like this. Fold it until the two end will reach, and then do adhesive joining methods to get the cylinder back. This is the applications of the development of cylinder. We'll solve a problem. A vertical cylinder of base diameter 45 mm, axis length 60 mm is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 50 degrees to HP, is passing through the center point of the top face. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the cylinder. In order to understand the meaning of lateral surface, please see my introductional video by subscribing to the channel Meg Learners Academy. So, two steps to solve the problem. First step, orthographic projection. Since we are following first quadrant system, our first angle of system, which comes like this, XY, above XY, you have got vertical plane, where front will be there, below XY horizontal plane, top will be there. As it is resting on HP, so you have to draw the top view circle with a diameter of 45 mm. Then, since it has not got the edges, we have to create generators. So divide the circle into a good number of divisions. So I divided the circle into how many divisions, we'll count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's a good amount. Why? Because if I make less number of divisions, then in developments, in order to join the cutting points from one point to another point, you won't get a smooth points or smooth curve. So in order to get it, go to a good like 12 divisions. So draw the vertical projectors, axis height 60 mm, draw the front view, it will be a rectangle. Then do the naming. As I explained in the earlier slide, cylinder means top circle, base circle. Top circle points are ABCD, base circle points are kept in bracket because they are away to the observer as A1, B1, C1, D1 like that, which is represented in the notations as you can see in the top view. B bracket B1 like that. Yes. And center O, O1 which represents the axis. So here, one by one, the front view notation is marked. Let me show once again. As I said earlier, this line represents the top surface of cylinder. This line represents the base of the cylinder. So here it has got A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L. Here it has got A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1, J1, H1, I1, J1, K1, L1, all the points. One by one, where I have kept the arrow mark or the cursor, observer will be standing here. To this observer, A is nearer and A1 is also nearer. So it can see. How? We'll see on the front view. A dash at the bottom, A1 dash. Like that, draw a line here, B dash, backside L, so which cannot be seen So it is in the bracket. It is not I, it is L in the lower case. Bottom B1 dash bracket L1 dash. I have reduced the font size in order to accommodate all the notations. Again at this point, draw a vertical line which represents C and K. So C dash bracket K dash here, C1 dash bracket K1 dash. Next, already I have drawn because which helped me to get the axis, which is D and J. D dash bracket J dash, bottom D1 dash bracket J1 dash. Next, at here, this line represents E and I. So here, E dash bracket I dash, at the bottom E1 dash bracket I1 dash. Next, one more vertical line which represents F and H. F dash bracket H dash, bottom F1 dash bracket H1 dash. And last one is G, which has already covered in the front view. G dash, bottom G1 dash. I got all the points. Next, I have to introduce the cutting plane. It's perpendicular to VP and inclined at 50 degrees to HP, that is theta, passing through the center point of the top face. Let me read it once again carefully. This cutting plane is passing where? Center point of the top face. I explained, this line indicates the top face of the cylinder, this line indicates the bottom face of the cylinder. So the cutting plane is passing the top face where? Center. You can see where I have kept my cursor. There, use the protractor by making an angle 50 degree, pass like this. 50 degree. I have taken a platform because this platform or horizontal line is parallel to top face. I have satisfied the condition which has been given in the problem. Now, to mark the cutting points. It has cut A dash, A1 dash at 1 dash. Next, I will drop it down and come here in the top view, which is also 1. Next, next line is having two lines, B and L. So let me mark this, which can be 2 dash. So I'll bring it down, which is at the top view B, which is 2. Next, let me mark the back points later. First cover the front points. Next line is C. 3 dash, drop a line which goes there. 3 dash, and next point is, here you can see, 4 dash, yes, that is D, and call this as 4. So the front points over, now the back points has to be represented in bracket. After 4, 5, which is in the bracket, 5 dash. So, which is J, you can see it on the top view here and represent it as 5. After 5, next one is 6, where it is on the K. After 6, next point is 7, where it is on L. Here you can see in the front view, 7 dash in the bracket, here 7. So I got 7 points. Now if you can have a look, the left side of the top view has been sectioned, right point it has not disturbed. The same thing you can see in the front view on the top face. Where I am moving the cursor, the cutting plane has not touched this. So that's why this surface remains same. That's why left side part of the top view is hatched. Hatching indicates that part is sectioned. Second step, development of lateral surface of the cylinder. Let me take this advantage of extending XY so that I can use the height. What is the length? Mark a point where I have kept a cursor. From this, use the formula pi d. D is equal to diameter 45. Pi into 45 is 142 mm. If you get fraction, round it off. Then draw this length. What is vertical height? Height is equal to 60. Then construct the rectangle. Sorry. Then you know that in the top view, how many divisions circle was made? 12 divisions. Like that, here in the development also, for this 142 dimension, divided by 12, whatever the fraction amount you will get with the divider or compass, starting from here where I have kept the cursor, mark on the horizontal line and get the 12 divisions. On each 12 division point, draw vertical line. Yes, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 divisions has been made. Now to do the namings, no small letter, no hyphen that like thing as we do in the front view because this is purely development. A1, B, B1. Like that you have to make all these points and finally back A1. Now here it is very easy. That's why I have drawn development by taking the help height 60 and drawing on the same XY line so that the cutting points can be easily transferred. Now carefully look on the front view. Cutting point 1 is on A line. Let me draw that. Okay, so I have stopped here at A1, so and mark this as 1. Next, I have got 2 and 7. Let me concentrate on 2. Where 2 is? 2 is on B line. So I have drawn an horizontal line until it has stopped at B. So mark this as 2. Next is cutting point 3. Where it is? On the line C. So I have drawn an horizontal line until it has touched C. So mark this as 3. Next, this one. Where it is 4. Where is 4? 4 is on D. So go to the D point where I can see the cursor. Yes, this is 4 point. I have marked 1, 2, 3, 4. Now my duty to mark 5, 6, 7. So 5 is also on J. As you can see in the front view, D dash bracket J dash. So go to J. Skip E, F, G, H, I and come to J. Mark a dot. This is 5. So on the 3, you've got bracket 6 dash. So extend this. Where is 6? It is on K. Extend this and mark 6. So on 2 you have got bracket 7 dash, that means on L dash. So extend this up till until it reaches L and mark this 7. And finally A. A means 1. Extend this line to get 1 back. Now we have marked the cutting points on the development. Now to make the thick line which represents the retained portion of the solid. Thin lines represents removable portion. So from A1 up to 1 thick line, and I also made the base as thick line, here also A1, and from here 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, take a proper geometrical instrument and make it as a smooth curve. It should not be a straight line. Since the surface of the cylinder is not edges or any other thing, it should be drawn a smooth curve like this. Then from 4 to 5, it should be a continuous thick line. 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 1, a smooth curve, and 1 to A1 back. So this is the sectional development of the cylinder. Hope you have understood. To finalize, in the front view, draw the vertical line which has to be this. Don't make the inner lines, which are generator lines, thick lines, because they are construction lines. Thank you.